I have a red and green 5mm LED. I got this in assortment of 20 LEDs, different shades, different sizes, from Radio Shack some time ago. And we're going to show you the characteristics of these two colors right here and how they differ. So let's get started with it right now. I'm Tom Kovichak, and this is Tom's Trains and Things. This channel was created to help other modelers who are in need of guidance in pursuing their dream of building a model railroad. Now, we've discussed Ohm's Law. We took a look at resistors and found out what they were all about. We figured out how to use a multimeter. And now we're going to talk about the LEDs. I got these two LEDs right here, a red and a green one. I'm going to show you a series of four different ones with four different resistors on it. And we're going to see the difference in the lighting in it. We're going to check the amperage on each one of them and show you the difference on it and give you a practical application of Ohm's Law, where when you increase the resistance, the amperage decreases, and vice versa. So let's get started with that right now. I'm going to take these bag of assorted LEDs that I got from Radio Shack some time ago and use these in a demonstration. Now, these are two different sizes. They're 3mm and the 5mm. Okay, I started my breadboard right here, and I put some jumpers from the power bus over to 1, 2, 3, 4 different lines, so we could test four different sets of LEDs at one time. So we'll just dump these out right here. Okay, here we go. We got two of each color, yellow, green, and red in the 3mm. And we got four greens, four reds, four yellows, and two clear in the 5mm. So let's see what we're going to do here. We're going to do a little experiment with the colors and resistors. What I'm doing in here is I'm going to make up four rows. I already have three of them in there, but I'm going to show you the diode or LED itself, and the long pin is the anode, the positive side, and the short one is the cathode, the negative side. And what I'm doing is I'm reversing things. So the green I'm putting on the positive side, and then the red I'm turning it around, because I'm going to show you how to use the reversing switch on here, and I'm doing it just the opposite. So I'm on the green, I'm putting the long one, the anode, on the left, and on the red, I'm putting the anode on the right. Turn the breadboard around so you can see it a little bit better. Now, this is the 10, 22, 47, and 68. Now, you're not going to see too much of a difference in it right now, but you're going to see a difference in the intensity of the green and the red. And the reason for that is every color has a different quality to it. They have a different starting voltage. For the red, the forward voltage is 1.8 to 2, and on the green the forward voltage is 2 to 2.3. So you see what it looks like on the green, and I'll take my reversing switch right here and switch it over to the red. And you can see the difference right there. And let me turn the lights out. All right, there's the red. And then there's the green. So you can't see that much of a difference in the green, but you can in the red on the 10 ohm. Now, these set of resistors, the one most on the left is 100 ohms. Then we have 220 ohms, 460 ohms, and 1K ohm. And let's see what that looks like here.
Now you'll see on the green, the first two you could barely tell the difference, but once you get up to 460, you could see how it's getting dim, and then up to 1K, it's really dim. Now let's switch it over onto the red. And you could see the red is more drastic on the 1K, and you could barely see any difference on this one here. It is a little bit dimmer, but not much. But you could see as the resistance increases, your light on your LED decreases on both the red and the green. Now the red, the green is less vibrant than the red, I think. In a video coming up shortly, I'm going to show you how to use this 10K linear potentiometer and a few resistors so you could determine the optimum brightness of your LED for your control panel or in a building or wherever else you want to have them. So keep looking for it. It'll be out pretty shortly. Okay, I switched them around so we could have both of them lighting up at the same time so you could see the difference in intensity on here. Okay, now this one is with the 220 ohm resistor, and you can see how much brighter the red one is than the green. And let me switch them around on all of them so they all come at the same time. Now that I have all of them turned the same way, so when I flip this switch over, it's gonna light them all up. Now you can see the difference in intensity. The red is more intense than the green, but when you have both of them lit on the same circuit, you could see how much difference it makes on the circuit. Now, this one over here is the 1K. Now, let me pull the red one out and show you what happens to the green. 100, 220, 470, and 1K with the green. So you can see what the resistance does with that. Now let's talk about the amperage on there. And let me set this up so I could show you the amperage. Right now I have the circuit set up where I could test the amperage on this green LED with the 220 ohm resistor. Now let me turn this thing on right here. So it's like 0.044, okay? Now let me move this over to the other one. So now with the 100 ohm resistor, it's 0.085. So as the resistance decreases, the amperage increases. That's your practical application of Ohm's law right there. So with a 100 ohm resistor and whatever value the LED is, you have 0.086 amps. With the 220 ohm resistor, you have 0.044 amps. Now I have the meter hooked up to the 470 ohm resistor and the LED. So let's see what we have right now. We have 0.023 amps. We have it on the 1K ohm, and now it is 0.008. But anyway, you could see the difference between the 100 ohm resistor and the 1K ohm resistor. Now with the LED in the circuit, it's 0.088. Now, let me take the green LED out and do it with a red LED. Now with the red LED, it's 0.101. So you can see the difference in the values between the green LED and the red LED. There's the green one. So that's 0.087. Now let's put the both of them together. They'll dim. And it's 1.01 together, 1.02. we decreased the resistance because we have the two in parallel. Now let me switch this over and put them in series and we'll show you what happens. Now I have the two LEDs in series. Let me switch these around here. And I have 0.068. So we increased the resistance by putting it in series and effectively decreased the amperage because we have the same voltage here. And what I did was, when I had it off cameras, I put it on 12 volts. So let me just take this and put this back over on 5 volts. Now we have this in series, and I'll just touch it on the terminal. And they're a little bit dimmer, and we have 0.008 amps on it. And you can see on there that it is dimmer because we have less voltage. The same resistance, but different amperage, different voltage. Now let's put it back on the 12 and see the difference on there. Now I'm going to show you what happens when you hook up an LED without a resistor in the circuit. Now here's the 12 volts. And boom, it just goes right out. That LED is no longer any good. Well, I hope you enjoyed my demonstration there and me blowing up that little LED. If you would like to see more videos like this, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And while you're at it, ding that bell. There you go. It worked that time. But leave a comment down below. And I have some more videos coming out. Now this, let me just see if I can get it up here. This switch right here, we saw that in the last video. I'm going to show you later on this week how I soldered that together with all those wires on there. So we'll have another soldering demonstration here. I still had the power on that. And I have more videos coming on electronic principles. I'll show you the one where I soldered this, and we'll discuss some other LEDs. We got some clear ones right here, and we have some square ones with four posts that are ultra bright LEDs. And I just picked up a package of Pico chip LEDs. These things are so small, the wire is heavier than the LED. I don't know if you can see it there, but the LED is right there where my fingertip is. That's the little LED, and it gets bright. So we're going to talk about a little bit of that. And later on, I am about to order 5-meter strip of LEDs where you could cut them off at 3 together. And we're going to do some projects with that also. So keep watching. And we got a lot of videos coming up on how to hook up your LEDs. And then don't forget, I'm going to show you how to hook them up on your tortoise switch machine and cobalt switch machine. And as soon as I figure out what number 3 is about, because I've been playing around with it, and it just gives you half the voltage of what you put in. So I'm not sure what their intention of was with using that as an indicator, because that's what they said it is. But anyway, it just indicates all the time that you have voltage on it whenever you have a voltage applied to your motor on there. So I'm going to be doing some more experimenting with it and find out what they mean by what they say about pin number 3 on the Cobalt Classic Omega. There we go, right there. So, and until then, we'll see you later on this week with some more projects. So, we'll see. Dee, 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 dee.